Let's talk for a little bit about how DMX actually works. Each light that you have for DMX can be set up on what they call a DMX channel. This one here is set up on DMX channel 261. All DMX channels will be somewhere between 0 or 1 and 512. And so what that does is it allows you to address each particular light. And again, this was a little bit confusing for me, and I want to try to clarify this. Each light, so let me go back just a little bit. With regular lights, regular old incandescent lights, where you would vary essentially the amount of intensity that the light would put out, each light would only have a single channel, and you would vary how bright the light was. And whatever color it was, you would just get either more red or more blue or more green or more white, because every light only did one color. So every light was a single channel, you had a single fader on your board, and that would run that particular light. These lights, the LED lights, work in a very different fashion. And these particular lights have many channels. And so, for example, if this light, well, let's say set to channel number 1, this light has actually, in its simplest configuration, 6 channels. And so it would be channel 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and 6. So it would take up 6 different channels out of the 512 that I have in my DMX, what they call a universe. And so the reason it takes up 6 is that you can control each part of the light independently. So you can control the amount of red, the amount of green, the amount of blue, the amount of white light, the amount of amber light, and the amount of ultraviolet. And so those 6 channels give you lots of control over how you mix your colors. However, for example, let's say you have a situation where you want red. The red would be at the maximum value, and all of the other ones would potentially be at their minimum values. If you wanted more of a pink color, maybe the other values would be slightly up, and then you'd have more red than anything else. And that's the way you mix the colors, is you mix them according to what the values are of each one of the different DMX channels. So, if you have lights that have a lot of channels, they can very quickly use up your DMX space. Like I said, you only have 512 channels. And for most small to mid-sized churches, 512 should probably be enough. Because when you get into using multiple universes, you then, to get more than 512, let's say to get 1,024, which would be two universes, you end up having to buy more expensive hardware and software in order to control that. Again, if you need it, you can totally do that. However, you would need to do some different things in order to make that happen. So, when you have a particular light, lights can be configured as to how many channels they have. This light has several different modes. In this case, it has on the back, and just, I'll go over this real quickly. Most of them have a single LED, and some of the newer lights actually have touch screens and things like that. Again, you're going to pay more for that, but the basic lights have this kind of configuration with typically 4 buttons. And the unfortunate part is that the 4 buttons rarely do the same things. And so you typically have to get out the book or kind of start pressing buttons until you get it to do what you need it to do. The nice thing is that most of the time, once you get these set, it's kind of like you can set and forget. So in this case, it's showing my DMX channel, DMX 296 or 261, and I can choose up or down to change that particular number. I can also press the menu button to access different types of different features in the light. Now in this case, there's a 6-channel mode, a 7-channel mode, and a 12-channel mode. And each one of those provides different kinds of features. Now, if you're controlling your lights with either a light board or an app, you really want to put your lights in the lowest number, to use the fewest channels as possible. So in this case, we'd want to use 6. Because the other features like strobing and different kinds of color effects and all that are nice, but they're primarily designed for DJs. And there's certain times when you may want to use those, and so you want to think about whether you want to use the most basic or whether you want to use one of the, like for example, the 6 versus the 12-channel mode. The advantage to using the 6-channel mode is that it takes up less of your DMX universe. Again, you only have 512 addresses in that space, and so by only using 6, you're going to get a much better bang for the buck when it comes to your space, and you're going to fill up your universe a lot more slowly than you would otherwise. So, again, my recommendations for this are choose the smallest number of channels that have the features that you want, and then you also can make sure that you're allocating your space. Well, we'll talk about space allocation here in a little bit. How do I decide what channel to assign each light to?